Given the global crisis, Qantas is looking like the kangaroo in the coal mine. Companies everywhere are confronting massive losses to earnings and revenue. But stock markets are almost as expensive as they've ever been. Damien Klassen is head of investments at Nucleus Wealth and joined me from Melbourne. Damien, Qantas has sent a pretty clear message today on where it thinks the economy is or isn't going. But we're seeing equity markets continue to surprise and be positive or heading into a positive direction. Does there seem to be a disconnect between equity markets and what's happening in the economy?
Oh, absolutely. And I think what we're seeing in terms of versus earnings are certainly falling at a rate that you typically expect to see during recessions. And they're pretty much as bad as you get in terms of the downgrades and the losses that we're seeing, and not just short-term losses. Now companies are starting to have a longer look and projecting those losses forward over the years, or certainly projected much lower profits. And on the flip side, we've got equities trading not that far off all-time highs. And if you pick some indices, they are at all-time highs. And so from a pricing perspective, you've basically got the economics as bad as we've ever seen. And on the flip side, we've got the pricing and valuations as good as we've ever seen. So there is this real disconnect at the fundamentals.
Are we in a bubble?
Absolutely. But it's a very different bubble. Usually a bubble's along the lines of earnings are growing along and relatively strongly, or at least not going backwards, and prices just run up in front of earnings. They sort of get overexcited about the prospects or whatever it is. We've actually had the opposite. We've had the floor fall away from us. So we've sort of had, forget the path we got to get here. Markets are sort of either flat or a little bit down in terms of which markets you're looking at, in terms of the price action over the last 6 months, whereas earnings have just dramatically fallen away, which leaves you in the same position of being in a bubble of the prices relative to the earnings.
Who's investing in equity markets? Is it new investors that are seeing this time as an advantageous time to get into the market? Robo-investing, institutional investors?
Yeah, sure. It's a little bit of a mix of a whole bunch of them. We look at sort of, to get a bubble, what you really need is you need this new money coming in. And especially right now, because there's so many companies doing capital raisings, companies making losses, companies raising more debt, you just need this constant stream of new money coming into the market to actually help prop it up, just to keep it where it is, let alone push it to new highs. And we have seen, we've seen sort of four main areas that we see where you can get new money from. One is increased debt. So you can see existing people taking on margin loans and other things. And you definitely saw that in the 2000 bubble for the tech, and you definitely saw that in 2007. You're not seeing it this time. So it's not a debt-driven, not a margin loan debt-driven. The second place is from, you can see new investors coming in. And this is one thing we certainly saw in the tech boom, was that everyone wanted to get a piece of the action. And we're seeing, by our estimate, we've seen in the US about 9 million new accounts so far this year. And to keep in perspective, and that's a little bit, the numbers are a little bit off, because 9 million, we don't know how many of those are double accounts. Whereas when we look at the number of households that have accounts in the US, there were only 17 million households that actually had accounts prior to, from last year. So the number of new accounts is significant. Secondly, they seem to be trading a lot in options and derivatives, and those tend to have a much greater effect. So in options and derivatives, you can put down, say a $5,000 investment with the hope of either making $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 or with a relatively high probability of losing the lot. But that does disproportionately affect the market more than if you actually just went out and bought $5,000 worth of stock. So that's our first three. The final one is people switching. So you can have so all three of those is new money coming into the investments. The last one is we've got a certain pool of investments, and we can have money switching around within that. So people can be selling say investment property and putting it into the stock market, or they can be selling bonds and putting it into the stock market. Now, one of those is very much central bank driven. So central banks are definitely trying to chase people out of bonds and into equities. And that's because a lot of their programs have been sort of front-loaded. We think that's part of what's driven it. The other thing, though, is that we're just starting to really see now government lending really start to take off. And so the issue is central banks, for example, have put in, or the US central bank, is, to use another one, has put in about $3 trillion into the market over the last few months. In the meantime, we think the US debt's only grown by about $1 or $2 trillion in that time frame. But it's going to keep. It's now going to start accelerating as companies, as its tax receipts don't come in, and as some of these programs start to spend more money. So the central banks are going to have to, if they want to keep putting more in than what's going out the other side, they're going to have to double and triple the amount of stimulus that they've done already just to keep the whole thing going, let alone other companies. And then the final place is again, this one's hard to judge, because you only really get surveys, but it's what are institutional investors doing? So we know retail investors are putting lots more money in. Institutional investors, we have to look at surveys about what they say they're doing. Now, the last survey that came out just about a week ago basically said that fund managers in general think this is one of the most expensive market. Well, sorry, they think it's the most expensive market ever since they've been running this survey for sort of 20 years plus. On the flip side, when you ask them what have they actually been doing, well, they've actually been increasing their equity exposures over that time frame, and hedge funds are pretty close to the top of the range that hedge funds trade at in terms of how much exposure they actually have to the market. So we sort of figure that there's probably not a lot more to come on that front. When everyone's underweight, there's actually the chance then that as institutions get in and start buying, that they push the market up. But we actually think they're relatively close to the top. And it's quite possible you'll see from 30 June, a lot of the superannuation funds and a lot of the pension funds, because the market's rallied so strongly, will actually have to sell equities post 30 June. Mm. So potentially, I guess we're getting close to the top, it seems to us, on all these measures.
There are indications that we may be about to see a second wave of COVID-19. What do you think markets will do in response to that?
It's pretty hard to tell. I mean, I think we've been looking at, we've been looking and saying, you know, if the disease got out of control, our view before this started was if the disease got out of the control in the US, that would be one catalyst to sort of bring markets down. The disease, you know, ex New York has never really been brought under control, especially a lot of the bigger states like Florida or Texas. It's never really been brought under control. And so I'd like to say, yes, I think this will be the thing that actually brings markets to the senses, but it hasn't really before. So it's hard to say whether that's going to be the factor. I guess I'm probably looking more at whether increased number of bankruptcies, especially among small and medium businesses, and as governments start to lift some of the moratoriums they put in on companies going bankrupt, that whether that's enough to trigger it. But yeah, it is very hard to know what's actually going to be enough to trigger it. And bubbles do often last far longer than makes sense from a fundamental perspective.
Reporting season just around the corner. Will that be a reality check for investors?
Possibly a little bit. I think for the issue for Australian companies is that you're going to get 6 months of earnings, and of that 6 months, two or three months of that were pretty good, and then the other two or three were pretty bad. And so I guess we're not expecting earnings down we're not expecting to see the full effect this time around. The US companies, you are going to see quite a bad round of it. I think that the key thing people are going to be looking for, though, is actually starting to get some more guidance from management. And I think the Qantas announcement you came out with today is a good indication of what's happening at companies. I think at the start, there were a lot of companies that figured this will just be a 2-3 month blip. And so, yes, we'll take the opportunity to lay off some staff and pull back on a few expenses. But if it's all going to come back in 2 or 3 months, we don't really want to make deeper cuts. And I think what we saw from Qantas today and what we're seeing increasingly from other companies right around the world is that second round of layoffs, with companies really extending their time frame and figuring, well, we're in this for a much longer haul. And so what we're expecting is we're really expecting to see companies starting to pull back their earnings expectations even further. And we think that could easily be a catalyst to bring the market back. And one other one is potentially the US election could be another. Joe Biden's got a range of policies about raising taxes, and that's certainly going to put a dent in company earnings. But again, it's that really hard to know what's... The market's been so glass half full on so many things. It's hard to see what will be the final straw that finally brings it back to reality on the earnings front.
Damien Klassen, thanks so much for your insights.
Thanks a lot.